All right, thank you, Marla, and hello, everybody. Good to see another full house. My goodness, this looks great. I'm not going to say too much because you want to hear this great band. Heard them before, about 5 years ago, kept trying to find Becky. She kept hiding from me. Finally, I ran into her by mistake at Walmart on the parkway. I said, when are you coming up on the show? She said, we'll be there. So here they are. And we'll get to the music in just a second, but first, I always say thank you to our veterans. So all you veterans out there, raise your hands. And let me say thank you. Let us say thank you to all of you, all you veterans everywhere, you veterans here at the Crooked Road General Store, and you veterans by way of television. Thank you so much for your service and sacrifices. Because of all of you, we are here. So now, if you will, please help me welcome to the old Southern porch. This is Gospel Grass.
No, that's exactly what gets us where we're going is the blood of Jesus. Amen? Amen. Praise God. I thank God for his blood. Amen.
Sits at the right hand of God the Father. Soon he'll be coming to take us away. He lives.
He lives.
Hallelujah. I used to believe. If the good outweighed the bad, that I had a place in heaven, for that I was so glad. But then the Holy Spirit convicted me of sin. I put my faith in Jesus, and now I'm really in. He died on the cross for our salvation. He rose from the tomb on the third day. He sits at the right hand of God the Father. Soon he'll be coming to take us away. Alpha, Omega, beginning and the end. The only one who's perfect, in him there is no sin. Yet he came from heaven to live inside a man. His holy name is Jesus, he's the man with the plan. He died on the cross for our salvation. He rose from the tomb on the third day. He sits at the right hand of God the Father. Soon he'll be coming to take us away. He lives. He died on the cross for our salvation. He rose from the tomb on the third day. He sits at the right hand of God the Father. Soon he'll be coming to take us away. He lives. He lives. He lives. He lives. Hallelujah.
Amen. Brother Mike wrote that song. So, did anybody ever hear the story? I heard a preacher telling the other day that Eve was really, really jealous. And she accused Adam of having an affair. He said, "What are you talking about?" He said, "You're the only woman alive." So he wakes up in the middle of the night, and his ribs hurt him real bad. And he looked over, and Eve was poking him in the ribs. And he said, "What are you doing?" She said, "I'm checking to see if he took another one."
Get it?
Keep thinking about it, you will.
That's right.
Oh, they tell me of a home far beyond the sky. Oh, they tell me of that land far away. Oh, they tell me. Tell me. Lord, he tell me that he smiles on his children there. He smiles our sorrows away. And they tell me that no tears ever come again in that motherland of unclouded days. Oh, the land of cloudless days. Oh, the land of an unclouded sky. Oh, they tell me. You guys, but I look forward to that day when Jesus returns. Amen. Praise God. I look for him at any time myself. According to the Word of God and what I know about the Word of God, Jesus said, when you see these things come to pass, look up, your redemption draweth nigh. Amen. Still over in the grave, so is Muhammad and all the rest of them, but Jesus rose and is seated at the right hand of the Father. Amen? Amen. Praise God. Now, not too fast. What a glad thought, a wonderful morning. Just you gave up troubles and I wake up. Seek no more. Rise to meet our blessed Redeemer. With a glad shout I'll leave the ground. I wake up. Sleep no more.
When I wake up,
sun that morning,
sleep no more.
Jewels and ornate,
so happy I'll be.
Glory, glory,
on a beautiful shore.
Tell the story with reading of all ages. Bring the one to my door.
When I wake up,
when I wake up,
sleep no more. Glory to God, I'll have a new body, changed completely of an eye. When I wake up,
sleep no more.
Leave behind all trouble and sorrow, bound for the city up on high. When I wake up, sleep no more.
When I wake up,
Sunday morning,
sleep no more. So happy I'll be. Story here before we do our next one. Heard this one the other day. He said this guy was elected to be the Indian chief and said he's a brand new Indian chief. Didn't know nothing about being an Indian chief. So the tribe come and asked him, said, how bad winter it's going to be? So he kind of just like, it's going to be bad winter. Cut a lot of white firewood. So the Indians went out and cut a bunch of firewood, you know. Said he got to thinking about it, so he said, I don't know what kind of winter it's going to be. So he called the meteorologist. He said, how bad winter going to be? The meteorologist said, going to be bad winter. So he goes back and tells his tribe, said, going to be real bad winter, cut more firewood. So he gets thinking about it again that night, and he calls the meteorologist. You sure it's going to be bad winter? He's going to be real bad winter, he said. So he goes back and tells his tribe, cut more firewood, going to be real, real bad winter. So he thinks about it again. He's called the meteorologist. He said, are you sure it's going to be bad winter? He said, bad, terrible winter. And he said, how do you know him it's going to be bad winter? He said, because the Indians are cutting the heck out of firewood.
Yeah, your turn.
Praise God. Did anybody know what that was? Yeah, there you go. Amen.
What a cornbread muffin.
Cornbread muffin. Okay, I'll tell you another one while she's tuning. Said these two ladies were sitting on top of the roof of their house in a big flood down in Louisiana. And one of them looks at the other, and she looks, and she sees a hat floating up this way, then it'll float down this way, and it floats back up that way, and it floats back down. She said, that one, she said, you see that hat out there? What that hat doing? She said, what is that? And she said, oh, that's my husband. She said, I told him he's going to mow today, come heck or high water.
Oh,
I can feel the wheels turning underneath my feet.
All right, don't clap too much. You'll give him the big head. No, we do a good job on that, too. Praise God.
Good night, Haynes. Y'all come back now here.
God bless you.
Appreciate you.
Yeah, good. Good.
He said he loved it very much.
Praise God.
Thank you.
Glad you know where that lifeboat is, amen. You know, old Noah preached, I believe the Bible said he, like 100 years, and nobody listened. There's only 8 souls got saved. And I believe with all my heart Jesus is coming back with a lifeboat very soon. Amen. You know, look up, guys. Look what's going on in the world. And Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. If you believe in God, believe also in me. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Got a guy with me that normally I can't talk to him until it's about 13 hours on the other side of the world or something, but he's my oldest son is here. He's sitting on the front row. He's a Wycliffe Bible translator. He's from Indonesia, Sintani, Indonesia. He and his wife and three children have been over there for about 20 years or so, and oldest son just went out to the Air Force Academy in Colorado, and he's going through basic training this week, the last couple weeks. The next son went to, he'll be going to England, some sort of music school or something. So, but anyways, he and his wife and Chris, the youngest girl, are here from Indonesia for a few weeks, so I'm glad to have him.
Amen.
I wonder what they chose to do on Monday night.
Yeah.
Mike, come up this way real quick, if you would. Come up this way.
Grab my wife
from
Indonesia
and
see gospel Christ.
Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah. Our reputation precedes.
One more time for Mike.
Yeah.
Yay. What we decided to do at the store tonight, stand up still.
Oh, sorry.
Oh,
sorry.
Well, hey,
she's going to hit you.
It's a rough crowd. You got to carry a ruler with you.
Yes. In Indonesia, we don't have a clue.
Yeah. Yeah.
But we know that you'll do what's right with it, right?
Amen.
Yeah.
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 No more darkness, no more saw the light. I saw the light. No more darkness. No more nights. Now I'm so happy. No sorrow in sight. Praise the Lord. I saw the light. Praise the Lord. I saw the light.
Children.
Go yonder, Moses, and smite that rock.
For
I am the Lord.
Jesus, you're on holy ground, holy ground, holy ground.
Take your
shoes off, Moses, you're on holy ground.
For
I am the Lord thy God. Stand still, Moses, see salvation work. Salvation work, see salvation work. Stand still, Moses, see salvation work.
Oh,
I am the Lord thy God.
Take your
shoes off, Moses, you're on holy ground. Holy ground, holy ground.
Take your
shoes off, Moses, you're on holy ground.
For
I'm the Lord thy God.
Master, what must I do? The old coat was ugly.
No, you don't.
Beneath the cleansing flood, I heard an old, old story, how Savior came from glory, how He gave His life on Calvary to save a wretch like me.
Me and I knew him, and all my love is He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing blood, beneath the cleansing
She pointed at him.
He's so difficult.
He is. He in trouble.
Yeah. Gary, bring my real pistol. All right.
Yep. Is the lighting okay?
Yeah, one more of it. Say one more verse of it.
All right.
We're gonna feature Brother Terry Taylor over here on the far left. That good looking tall one over there on the end.
Go ahead, rub it in. Could
we feature any mom?
Yeah.
I guess you're enough.
Stand up, stand up.
Yeah. Keep it up, keep it up.
Y'all ready?
Yep.
What to do. 12 disciples are my road. things in heaven. No rough roads along the way. And I'm using my Bible for a map. My last stop is heaven some sweet day. My last stop is heaven some sweet day.
Gonna swap gears here real quick, and while we're at it, I'll tell you another little story where we went to church.
Y'all done agged him on.
You probably may have already heard this, and this old man and woman was in church, and they'd been there for 60 years, I think it was, or they'd been married for 60 years, and the man stands up and said, I want to tell everybody, after 60 years of marriage, my wife's been tried and true. And she looks up at him. She said, what did you say? He said, I told her after 60 years of marriage, you've been tried and true. She stands up and said, well, after 60 years of marriage, I'm tired of you too. If somebody lost her hubcap, I think Mike found it and he put it on a guitar, and we're going to see how it sounds. We're going to try it out.
That sounds
Thank you. sign upon his precious skin. I will know my Savior when I come to him. But mark with nails have been. But mark with nails have been.
And the winner is...
Yippee!
Joyce!
It's rigged.
Yeah.
Oh, Lordy.
Good job.
Where'd she go?
Oh, okay.
She did.
Joyce Justice. The name sounds familiar. Joyce Justice. Joyce, we've heard your name plenty of times, but we've heard your dad's name a whole lot more. Tell the folks who your dad was.
My dad was Curly King.
Yeah.
Curly King in the Tennessee Hill Coffers.
Yeah, all right.
Pretty awesome stuff. Let's give her a great big hand here.
We'll
trade it in. This is actually Dale Ann Bradley's newest CD, which will not be released until August the 1st.
And so there's her latest
release. It's self-titled Dale Ann Bradley, and she has lots of guests on there like Steve Gulley and Vince Gill and those. And so one she worked really hard on. It's released on August the 1st. Let's hear it for our winner.
Yay!
Raspberries.
Nobody gonna come to
try one here. I think we got two more we're going to try, but thank y'all so much for staying with us and hanging in there. I'm hanging in there like a hair in a biscuit myself. I've been going since about 4:30 this morning. But, yeah.
They get worse. Don't encourage it.
That's pretty bad, isn't it?
Yes, it can.
Yeah.
What do you call two fleas on a bald man's head? Homeless.
Did you just make that up?
Me they.
You will not get paid this weekend.
Add another zero to my pay. That's okay.
For Jeff, this song is about Jonah, and our youth, not too long ago, Blake and I, the boy in the back, we teach sixth grade at our church, and we just went through the book of Jonah, and we've taught it many times, but every time you read it, it reminds you, it's just a new conviction every time, because it doesn't matter what you're doing, where you're going, if God wants you to be somewhere, he's just going to push you there. You can't run from it, you're not going to be able to hide, because he can see you. And this song, just listen to the words of this song. It's pretty much the story of Jonah. But I encourage anybody in the house tonight to go home and read that book.
I don't know what happened. It just all of a sudden went boom.
Yeah, that's right.
The devil just didn't want you to sing that song.
The hardware malfunction.
Good Lord, mercy.
Good. Like musical guitar.
Musical guitar.
I don't know why it just went so bad.
Went south.
Yeah.
God sent Jonah to the Nineveh land. Preach the gospel to the wicked men. Tell them to repent of the wicked way.
Overthrow the city in 40 days.
God moves in a windstorm. He rolled
in a windstorm.
God moves
in a windstorm. And he troubled everybody in their mind.
Jonah went down to the seashore to make up his mind which way to go. Boarded the ship and paid his fare.
God got angry with Jonah down there.
God moves in a windstorm. He rolled
in a windstorm.
God moves
in a windstorm.
And he troubled everybody in their mind. Jonah went down from the side of man. Called on Jesus to be his friend. Disobeyed God and had to pay.
The Lord sent a storm on the water that day.
God moves in a windstorm. He rolled
in a windstorm.
God moves
in a windstorm. And he troubled everybody in their mind.
Cast poor Jonah overboard. God sent a whale and swallowed him whole. Went on down to Nineveh land.
Laid poor Jonah on a bed of sand.
God moves
in a windstorm.
He rolled
in a windstorm.
God moves
in a windstorm.
And he troubled everybody in their minds. Jonah rose up from the sand. Went on walking to Nineveh land. Preached the gospel at his command.
Repent, you wicked man.
God moves
in a windstorm.
He rolled
in a windstorm.
God moves
in a windstorm.
And he troubled everybody in their mind.
God moves in a windstorm. He rolled in a windstorm. God moves in a windstorm. And he troubled everybody in their mind.
Taylor and Shannon's going to sing a song. And we'll get off here and let them do that last one. Show here a little bit. The rest of them were just auditioning, and apparently they didn't make it. So these are the ones they kept. This is the final cut right here.
That's
right.
The last shall be first. You tell them that.
I'm going to take just a couple of minutes here, real quick, to run down the lineup of who we had up here. First of all, let me say that the young people that we have in this group is truly a blessing. They just bring so much into it and help us along. And it just thrills my heart to know that there are young people still interested in doing what we do. And even though with their talents and the skills that they have in music, they could be somewhere else doing something else. But they chose to be part of a gospel band. And that there's just something in that's just rare these days. For these young people to come and want to sing with us and play with us and take time out of their busy schedule to practice. And yeah, we do practice. So but we just enjoy them so much. And let me just run down the lineup real quick. Who's she stepped out. She'll be back. I could embarrass her, but I better not.
Tell her hurry up, Jordan. Hurry up, we're waiting on you.
This young lady has been a blessing to us. She's comes all the way from Chinkapin, Tennessee. Chinkapin. This is Miss Taylor Hicks. She's the engaged young lady we were talking about earlier. She's got some kind of a big rock or something she found.
And,
She went all the way to Hawaii to find that thing, so I'm not. And when I saw the picture, this poor old boy she was marrying was down on his knees. Now, I don't know. He was begging her. I'm not sure what took place. Huh?
Well, I had to go all the way to Hawaii to find him, so.
Y'all make welcome Miss Taylor Hicks. Young lady back here with her, they're getting ready to do a little duet here, and it'll just bless you tremendously. But let me first of all say, Taylor come through the Bluegrass program down at ETSU, and this young lady also come through that Bluegrass program as well. And she comes all the way up from Louisiana. When she come up here to school, she liked it so well, she decided to stay, and we're glad of it. And her mama makes some of the best jelly you'll ever eat in your life. Let me tell you. It's good. Shannon Gitro, make her welcome, please. The fellow that was up here just a minute ago, if the camera wants to pan around, he was standing there playing the banjo. And he comes all the way from Piney Flats, Tennessee, Mr. Mike Martin. The big, tall, goofy joke feller in the middle. All the way from Bristol. Mr. Jeff Taylor, make him welcome if you will. All the way. It's a long drive. The lady that did all the smiling keeps us straight, prints out the set list for us and keeps us on the bookings and stuff, and she's a tremendous help to me, a blessing to me, and just many times I've been wanting to just kind of not do this anymore, and it's her encouragement along with my wife that just, no, can't quit yet. Let's go. So she keeps me going, and I'm glad she does. And she lives in no man's land. She has a Bluff City address. She pays her taxes in Bristol, Tennessee, and a Bluntville phone number. We're not real sure where she lives, but we're glad she's here. Y'all make welcome Miss Becky Wise on the mandolin. And the fellow that was standing over here playing the rhythm guitar, he's been with me for quite a while, and we appreciate him so much. He's a tremendous help. He's standing behind the wall over here. We'll get him to come out and make his entrance. And he makes his way all the way up here from Bluff City, Tennessee, Terry Taylor. Another fellow that was standing back here beside me when I was back here in the corner, he helped me hold up the corner. But he also makes his way from Chinkypin, Tennessee. We'll get him to stand up. Mr. Blake Blevins on the rhythm guitar. And I don't normally like to introduce myself, but probably none of the rest of them will come up here and do it. My
name.
Thank you. Thank you very much. My name is Gordon Justice, and we've been a part of Gospel Grace for 31 years. It's all yours, ladies.
This song is called Battlefield, and Shannon's just too good of a guitar player for you to not get to hear her tonight, so that's why we're gonna do this song. One day, as I was thinking on unseen things above, the Savior spoke unto me, and he filled my heart. Beginning or just
yes,
a little
yeah,
bit more?
Just break it up.
Thank you.
thanks again to this great band, Gospel Grass. Know that you can go smiling out and still let people know that you love the Lord. It doesn't have to be a sad and dismal time. So enjoy yourself this week, and we'll see you next Monday, right?